and gentlemen, Miss Kathy Lee Gifford.
Good evening, everyone. How are you? Are you having a good time? What about this ship? Can you believe you're on a ship? Is this the most beautiful thing you've ever seen?
Look at this, a promenade as wide as any street. A boulevard with ocean views and lights beneath our feet. And look at this, an atrium covered by a dome. I've never seen anything quite as grand back home. And here's a sight I'm telling you nobody should miss. And look at this. Your royalty, floating in a swimming pool that's floating on the sea. And look at you, you're feasting like you're millionaires, toasting to a fantasy far from all your cares. This is what life should be, this is surely bliss. And look at this. And look at this, a moon that shimmers in our way. Then look at this, a twinkling sky with a thousand wishes on each star. And when he looks at you, he won't believe how beautiful.
You know, the Superliner Fantasy is the biggest, most spectacular 3 and 4 day cruise ship in the world. In fact, she was specifically built for 3 and 4 day cruises, and she's the perfect place to go for a great tropical vacation. Okay, you've seen a little preview. Now let's take a closer look at this floating resort. Shall we start below or at the top? Let's start at the top. Like to exercise? Well, the Nautica Spa aboard the Superliner Fantasy is the largest spa afloat. But then what would you expect from the largest 3 and 4 day cruise ship? The jogging track, for example, spans the entire sun deck. There's a completely equipped gym, too, with all the latest exercise equipment. You know, I used to hate to work out, but after enjoying the Nautica Spa gym, I swear by the treadmill. We also have an aerobics room, whirlpools, inside and out on deck, sauna, massage rooms, and you can get complete European facials and body massages from specially trained personnel. We even have special Nautica Spa selections as part of our regular dining room menus for those who like to watch their diets. Hey, we have it all. If you're into fitness, this fits the bill. Of course, if you prefer more traditional fare, our dining rooms offer menu selections as complete and diversified as any fine restaurant anywhere. And they're recognized by the International Gourmet Society, known as the Chaîne de Rôtisserie. Every night you have a new choice of appetizers, soups, main entrees, vegetables, desserts, and pastries made fresh daily in our bakery on board. And every meal and snack is included in the price of your cruise. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner is served in either our Jubilee or Celebration dining rooms. Both are beautifully situated on an upper deck with panoramic views of the sea. Or if you just can't leave the pool deck, you can have lunch or an early morning coffee in your bathing suit poolside. You can enjoy everything from a salad bar with a wonderful array of farm fresh vegetables, fruit, and assorted dressings, to a grilled hot dog, burger, or barbecued chicken. And as if that weren't enough, we have a midnight buffet for those who like midnight snacks. We even have a late night buffet at 1:30 a.m. for night owls. And if you're the type who likes snacks in your room, and who doesn't, we offer complimentary room service 24 hours a day. Now that's for me. But right now, how about some entertainment? This is the Universe Lounge, the biggest, most spectacular seagoing showroom in the world, and it's cooking. Our Universe Lounge also hosts the Captain's Cocktail Party, a beautiful reception where you can meet the captain, dance, and enjoy cocktails and hors d'oeuvres on the house. What else is there to do on board? What would you like to do? This is Century Boulevard. Believe me, this is where all the action is. It runs the entire length of the ship, all the way from the Grand Spectrum up there to the Crystal Lounge, all the way down there at the back of the ship. If you'd like something cold, you can enjoy a drink at the 21st Century Bar. It's the most popular bar on the ship. Maybe that's because it's open to the wee hours of the morning. It's a wonderful place to meet new friends or just to meet. Hi. Look at this. This is Cat's Lounge, inspired by the wonderful Broadway musical Cats. Quite an entryway, huh? A giant turned over tin can. Maybe they should have called this place Tin Can Alley. Ba-dum-bum. If you're looking for a nice place to get to know someone new, enjoy a little refreshment and dance to something slow and romantic, Cats is your kind of place. On the other hand, if a wild and lively disco turns you on, you'll love the beat of the Electricity Discotheque. If you're a night owl, stop by the Midnight Special in the Crystal Lounge. You'll see an entirely new show every night at sea. Or if you like to get into the act, you can join the sing-along crowd at Cleopatra's, a lounge that would do a pharaoh proud. Or if you prefer a quiet place, there's the quiet elegance of the classic Majestic Bar. Or you can watch the world go by and enjoy a cappuccino at the bustling Bistro Cafe. Or you can go out on deck with a newfound friend or renew an old friendship under the twinkling stars of the Bahamian sky. You know, one of the nicest things about a fantasy vacation is island hopping in the Bahamas. And whether you hop from island to island on a 4-day cruise or hop around Nassau on a 3-day cruise, you can do it better in the Bahamas.
Island hopping, once you start, there's just no stopping. Hop over here, hop over there.
Wonderful hats.
Big welcome smiles.
Big welcome mats. Diamonds and pearls, emeralds and gold.
Beautiful girls.
Traffic stopping.
Horses clapping.
People shopping.
I love shopping.
There's nothing like
island hopping, island hopping. There's one place you should plan on stopping.
Crystal Palace, where the beach is whopping. People are surfing, people are flying, and tanning their tummies and belly flopping at Crystal Palace. Wheels are spinning, cards are slapping, dice are rolling, people clapping, girls are dancing,
stars are singing,
wine is pouring, corks are popping, bells are ringing, coins are dropping. Some of the people are spinning and grinning. Why are they grinning? Because they are winning. The fun is going, it's never stopping. You'll find out when you're island hopping.
Island hopping, island hopping. Once you start, there's just no stopping. Hop over here, hop over there. Island hopping, island hopping. Once you start, there's just no stopping. Hop over here, hop over there. shopping. Once you start, there's just no stopping. Hop over here, hop over there. Island hopping, island hopping.
Shop! Oh, after all that island fun, it's nice to have a relaxing place to come home to. This is a veranda suite. I think they're just beautiful. Has twin beds that convert to king size, television, VCR, beautiful bar, walk-in closet, and my favorite part, most beautiful bathroom with a whirlpool tub. That sounds great right now. We also offer demi-suites. Sweet, huh? We have 54 suites with private verandas, but you'll find the fantasy staterooms unusually spacious too, especially when you compare them to other ships. In fact, we don't like to brag or anything, but you can fit the staterooms on those other ships inside this one. All right, so I bragged. You'll find closed-circuit television with feature movies, twin beds that convert into king size, and look at this, lots of closet space, plus a few comforts you don't have at home. Like room service. Looks good, doesn't it? You can get room service 24 hours a day. I recommend breakfast in bed. You know what's really fun about a fantasy cruise? Actually cruising on the fun ship Fantasy. There's so much to do. Let's see. I could find my own little place in the sun on over an acre of sun deck.
Or I could swim in one of three refreshing pools. Join in the fun and games. Enter the limbo contest. Trap shoot. Take a tour of the bridge, play bridge. Watch the horse races, go to the wine and cheese party, get my hair styled, have tea, watch an ice carving demonstration, go shopping. You think that's all, folks? No, there's much more. I could go to the library, I could watch a movie, I could enter the talent show, I could play bingo, I could walk a mile, I could tour the galley, I could do aerobics, play the lottery, go to the casino. That's what I'll do, I'll go to the casino, I feel lucky. Cody was born on March 22nd, so I'm going to put all of this on 22. Come on, 22.
All right, 22.
Go, Cody!
Okay.
Should I push my luck? Why not? It's always been my fantasy to win one of these jackpots. I'm feeling lucky tonight.
Say the word, say fantasy, and suddenly a dream you've dreamed will magically come true. Fantasy, fantasy, a ship with awesome majesty, a fun-filled trip that opens up a magic world for you. Don't say you can't afford to be sailing on a shining sea, seeing tropic islands in the sun. Don't say you don't have time to go to make new friends you'd love to know, having fun and playing in the sun. Fantasy, fantasy, just say the word, say fantasy. A dream you dream will magically come true. So when your world seems cold and gray, you feel the need to run away. All you have to do, all you have to do is say, fantasy, fantasy. Say the word, say fantasy. All you have to do, all you have to do is say fantasy, fantasy. Say the word, say fantasy. All you have to do, all you have to do is say fantasy, 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 fantasy.
An eagle soars overhead while orca and humpback whales tumble through icy waters. Nearby, a bear is spotted, and you get to see them all from your front row seat on board a small, intimate cruise ship. Hello, I'm Paul Ryan. As a travel reporter, I've experienced firsthand the world of Alaska Sightseeing Cruise West, and I'm proud to welcome you aboard. This is a company that allows you to experience the beauty and grandeur of Alaska and the Pacific Northwest in a way no other company can. Up close, where you can reach out and touch it. Come travel with us where the big ships camp, in the wake of Lewis and Clark, up the Columbia River, through the jewel-like San Juan Islands of Washington State, and to stunning Princess Louisa Inlet in British Columbia. But first, we venture far north, north to Alaska. By the way, what you're about to see recently won the prestigious Lowell Thomas Travel Journalism Award as the best video in the travel industry. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. Can adequately describe Alaska. No photograph can do it justice. It is more than a vast and abundant land. It is a treasure trove of life, a spectacular showcase for the power of nature. To really appreciate Alaska, you have to experience it. And the closer you can get, the better.
Oh my God! Oh my God! Oh!
Everybody in the world should see this. Well, I think the only word that can describe that is just, it's awesome.
It's gorgeous, it's awesome, it's wonderful. It's like another version of the beginning of the Earth.
There they are.
Oh, that's a big one.
It's a treat, like Alaska opens up a little pocket and says, look, oh, there it goes.
This is the life of Southeast Alaska. Here, the small cruising yachts of Alaska Sightseeing Tours inch their way through the 1,200-mile-long maze of wilderness waterways called the Inside Passage. This is a very special part of Alaska, teeming with wildlife and breathtaking scenery. While many large cruise ships steam nonstop through these waters in a single night, the small yachts of Alaska Sightseeing Tours venture deeper, exploring the heart and soul of Alaska. We offer you the option of two styles of cruising, daylight yacht touring and overnight yacht tours. Both options give you the ethereal, narrow passages of misty fjords and spectacular glacier scenery. Alaska Sightseeing Tours will bring you closer to Alaska than any other carrier. This unique mode of exploring the true inside of the Inside Passage is a concept developed by the man known as Mr. Alaska, Chuck West.
You seen those mountain goats up there today? Bought those down specially for you.
You brought them down for me?
Yeah.
Well, that's very nice of you. The guys with the cruise.
Yeah, right. That's typically Alaskan scenery.
After years of developing tourism in Alaska, Chuck West realized that while many visitors aboard the megaliners were dressing for dinner and dancing in discos, the wildlife and grandeur of Alaska was passing by unnoticed.
We sail close to shore. We see the animals up close. We look them right in the eye. We see the whales jumping close by. Porpoises following the ship. We see the deer on the beach. We see the bear with their cubs looking at us from just almost arm's length. These things are unique to our operation. And only with us can that be experienced.
The daylight yacht, Sheltered Seas, captures the essence of the personal, up-close Alaskan adventure. By cruising only during daylight hours, passengers witness all of the spectacular sights and sounds of this magnificent wilderness. With its unobtrusive presence, the ship seems almost to attract the majestic whales and playful porpoises.
Makes your heart beat fast, and you get excited and you scream and yell.
You don't see these things. These are real, free, wonderful creatures.
The Sheltered Seas explores the intricate waterways of the Inside Passage only during daylight hours. At night, passengers sleep ashore in ports such as Juneau, Petersburg, and Ketchikan. These overnight stops afford passengers a chance to savor the real Alaska. The quaint fishing village of Petersburg is virtually unknown to large cruise ships. Here you can relax and soak up the neighborly atmosphere, as well as the flavor of Petersburg's Norwegian heritage. Tracy Arm, a glass of glacier ice water is just within reach when the Sheltered Seas brings you right beneath a cascading waterfall. As you journey through time, the Sheltered Seas transports you into the ice age of LeConte Glacier. You now have a front row seat at one of nature's most spectacular shows.
Right there.
Probably the most incredible thing I've ever seen.
You feel a part of it. You don't feel like you're a visitor. You feel like you're a part of what's here. And that's the difference between this and a cruise show. I'm a part of what's happening.
Wow, a big shooter! A big shooter! A big shooter!
Just came up, dead ahead. Look at
him! Oh,
yeah! There. What a punctuation mark. I think it's one of the wonders of the world. I don't see how anybody cannot be emotionally moved by seeing this. I think it's absolutely glorious.
I toast you, the glacier, and the Sheltered Seas. Here, here.
Tanner Crab, King Crab, we've got the spirit of Alaska.
For the ultimate sleep aboard cruise at the Inside Passage, you just can't top the spirit of Alaska. From its home port of Seattle, the spirit of Alaska makes an 8-day trek north, hugging the coast of British Columbia, passing through misty fjords and spectacular glaciers on its way to Juneau. The ship then exchanges passengers and repeats the voyage south. This is the first American flagship since 1954 offering Alaskan cruises directly from Seattle. The Spirit of Alaska expands the concept of small boat cruising with a full range of accommodations, from ample to indulgent. Unlike the large cruise ships, this ship is more like a floating home than a floating hotel. The crew treats you like family. The meals are gourmet American, with the emphasis on fresh-caught seafood, fresh-baked goods, and other skillfully prepared delicacies. You can leave your formal wear at home. These dinners are strictly come-as-you-are.
It's a frontier experience. People don't show off up here. They're natural. The people enjoy each other. They don't have to wear a tie. Come to dinner as you are. Be relaxed, be friendly, be casual. You're here to enjoy Alaska, experience Alaska, not to experience the inside of the ship.
We've been on other cruises on the big cruise ships, and we've had the dancing and the dining and the entertainment and all the hoopla, and we thought something like this would be just a wonderful change of pace.
Happy Hallelujah to you. Congratulations to you.
It's like a family atmosphere. I mean, these people are like your family. You're living right next door to them. You're eating with them every day. And we're laughing and we're meeting wonderful personalities on the trip. And we hope to see some of these people afterwards.
The only ice sculptures you will see are the ones that float by the ship. There are no discos on board. The wildlife is all outside. No aerobics either. Passengers here get a different kind of exercise.
I don't find that particularly exciting, getting all dressed up and having high tea at 4 o'clock. And that's not Alaska. This is Alaska. Blue jeans and coats and running back and forth to see what's going on each side, and it really just makes it all part of it, all part of being here.
The itinerary for the Spirit of Alaska cruise is a cultural feast. Start with Seattle and the sights, sounds, and salmon of the Pacific Northwest. Cruise along the lush British Columbia coastline of Canada. visit Ketchikan, the salmon capital of the world, and also a gold mine, for exploring the totems and history of the American Tlingit Indian tribe. Enjoy the welcome and character of Little Norway in Petersburg, and see the mingling of Russian-American influence in Sitka. Although there is much to do and see on land, the real adventure of the Spirit of Alaska cruise unfolds between ports. While the cruise itself is often peaceful, the magnificent scenery changing at every turn is a thrill to see. A century ago, prospectors came to Alaska looking for gold. Today, you can still find Yukon gold. It shimmers off the water with the setting sun. Passengers are also rewarded with the pride and satisfaction of seeing our nation's symbol, the bald eagle, thriving in these protected forests.
We're doing what the big ships can't do. We're getting in these narrow places that the big ships can't go. We're stopping. We see a bear, we stop. That's what we're here for. We will go up, we'll get close to see it. Also, we're getting closer to the whales. We're getting some really good whale experiences, and we have time to see and do. And that's what the people are here for. The people that are coming on our cruises have read up. They're here to see Alaska and to do Alaska rather than for the cruise experience.
The only time the Spirit of Alaska seems insignificant is when it's dwarfed by a mammoth wall of ice. Your most exhausting experience is trying to keep up with the flow of emotions caused by being this close to nature.
Misty fjords must be magic. Every time I cry. Every time we go in there, I expect little elves and nymphs to pop out of the trees. And it's green, and there's mist trailing in the trees, and the engines are off, and it's so quiet that you can hear the birds, and you can hear the waterfall in the background, and it's just magical. It's just, I don't know, it really speaks to your heart. It's beautiful.
Seeing the glaciers up close and just, it's just phenomenal, just seeing the ice and the blue colors, and then the seals, and then the bears, and just the wildlife. It's just beautiful.
I came up here to restore my faith in Mother Nature. It's terrific.
We're showing you, I have to say it again, up close. See Alaska up close. And that's what we're doing. You're seeing Alaska from an intimate viewpoint. That is important. Alaska's here to be enjoyed.
From the daylight yachts like the Sheltered Seas to the overnight sleep-aboard yachts like the Spirit of Alaska, you will find that Alaska Sightseeing Tours has a vacation that's right for you.
We deal with people by name. We don't herd them through Alaska. We take them by the hand and lead them to Alaska.
Alaska Sightseeing Tours offers a complete variety of land, air, and sea tours to expand your exploration of America's last frontier. For more information, contact your travel agent or call Alaska Sightseeing Tours today to begin your intimate Alaskan adventure. It's difficult to find a land that matches the beauty of Alaska, difficult but not impossible. A spectacular waterway forms the boundary between the states of Oregon and Washington, and it's the largest river system in the western United States. Come with Alaska Sightseeing Cruise West now for a journey of 1,000 miles on the magnificent Columbia and Snake Rivers. It was Thomas Jefferson who said, "Find and follow the rivers that will carry you west from St. Louis to the Pacific." It was a challenge that stirred the imagination and sent Meriwether Lewis and William Clark on their epic 2-year adventure across the continent. On October 16, 1805, Lewis and Clark reached the mythical river of the West, the Columbia.
so wonderful. This is a very, very beautiful place.
It's a lark, and that's our style.
I have a terrible feeling that I had a better breakfast this morning than Lewis and Clark ever had. But it's nice to think they were here once. It's exciting to follow them.
Nearly two centuries later, modern-day Lewis and Clarks now ride the mighty Columbia in the bow wake of the original explorers on their own journey of discovery with Alaska Sightseeing Cruise West.
Wow, here's something that they never thought existed, wow, this is amazing. It's the largest river system on the West Coast, but nobody ever has thought of it before as being a cruising river.
Hello, welcome aboard the Spirit of Discovery.
This is an intimate cruising experience, your home away from home, on board one of Cruise West's unique yachts, accommodating fewer than 90 passengers.
This is our first small boat that we've been on. We have been on the much bigger ones, which tend to concentrate on shows and more food than you can possibly eat. But on this boat, it's friendlier. You get to know most people. It's much more fun, I think, to be on a small boat.
Your week-long journey begins in the Rose City, Portland, Oregon. From there, you venture up the Columbia, onto the Snake River, to the Idaho border, and the towns named in honor of the famous explorers, Clarkston, Washington, and Lewiston, Idaho. The trip upriver and back down all the way to the Pacific is a journey of 1,000 miles. An unforgettable experience, says Alaska Sightseeing President Dick West.
It's absolutely fantastic out here. It's like a Grand Canyon that people don't know about. There's a river system with the largest network of locks and dams in the Western world.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, once again, we've just entered John Day Lock and Dam.
The locks and dams have made the Columbia a very different river from what Lewis and Clark found. They explored a wild river that dropped 750 feet along its course with churning rapids. The dams have tamed the river. The locks make it navigable.
Pretty easy today, not much wind.
It's an amazing experience as your captain navigates the boat into the locks. Gigantic elevators closing, filling with water, lifting you 70 feet or more straight up to the next level. And the price of passage through the locks? Just a couple pieces of pie from the ship's galley for the lockmaster. And your journey continues.
It's such a relaxing trip. I just took a nap. I never sleep before lunch.
But between those periods of relaxation are moments you will always remember. All along the river, there are surprises. Perched high on a bluff is a mansion called Maryhill, originally the home of a wealthy businessman, now a museum containing rare works of art.
Oh, well, way out in the boondocks. Who'd believe it?
Another 3 miles upriver, something else almost equally unbelievable, and built by the same man. A replica of Stonehenge. This one, a tribute to the fallen of World War I. Venturing up the Columbia, you come to the breadbasket of the Northwest. The wheat fields, the orchards, and the opportunity to visit one of Washington State's finest wineries.
I did not realize that Washington had been used to this degree. This is lovely, and I'm very impressed with the size of the vineyard.
And there are historic sites to be visited. A once-in-a-lifetime chance to stand in the ruts left by the wagons that traveled the Oregon Trail. You will feel the pioneer spirit.
Oh, you bet.
Very much so. Very much so. We read a lot about it to begin with and studied it, but there's nothing like hands-on the sight to really bring it home to you.
All aboard!
Another side trip will take you on a scenic historic railway. You will climb the riverbank, up the mountain, through the apple orchards, and enjoy a breathtaking view of Oregon's snow-capped Mount Hood.
Oh, I think the train ride's great. It's fun. It's fun because the people are fun, too.
But there's even more fun and thrills in store. Hang on to your hat. You have now reached Idaho's Hell's Canyon and the Snake River Rapids. You're taken on a thrilling jet boat ride that zigs and zags through the 4,000-foot deep canyon.
Very exhilarating. And of course, I really wanted to see the Hell's Canyon, and it was better than I thought it would be.
Oh, wonderful. It was great.
Just like a roller coaster. Wouldn't have missed it for anything.
All that excitement works up quite an appetite, but it's soon satisfied by a hot lunch at a wilderness lodge deep inside the canyon. And we might add, the trip is both safe and comfortable. And you will share this wild river with its spectacular wildlife. And come within arm's reach of etchings left by the Indians who traveled this region hundreds of years ago.
We have a generation of people who've enjoyed life all our lives, and we're going to keep on doing everything we can to cram it in, and this is a wonderful adventure to add.
Unlike a lot of cruises, all of these side trips and onshore excursions are included in your Columbia and Snake River itinerary. Back aboard ship, it's time to reflect on the experiences of the day. Time to share those moments with newfound friends, both passengers and crew.
The crew are fantastic. They're very, very nice, and they're very efficient. And they're very, very, very polite, very good.
And what could be better than a very good chef preparing a very good and very large fillet of salmon?
That looks great. Boy, that's wonderful.
On board, there is a selection of entrees to suit every taste. And the food, as much as possible, is drawn from the area through which you travel. Real Northwest fare, coastal salmon, Idaho trout, sweet Oregon onions, Washington apples, and local beverages.
I think that Lewis and Clark would have been thrilled to finally smell that sea that we're smelling this morning.
You have cruised all the way up the Columbia to Idaho and all the way back down to the Pacific. Now you are at the very spot reached by Lewis and Clark on November 7, 1805. A monument in Seaside, Oregon marks their historic arrival. Following a morning visit to the riverfront fishing town of Astoria, Oregon, you again pick up the trail of Lewis and Clark. You visit the spot where they spent the winter in a small log fortification, Fort Clatsop, now a national monument. Then it's on to the nearby coastal town of Cannon Beach, Oregon. You can browse the shops or stroll the beach, the perfect place to reflect on your trip and the achievements of these two great explorers.
I certainly have a much greater appreciation of what they did, much greater awe of what they did. You know, I had no understanding of what all they accomplished until I came on this trip.
Alaska Sightseeing Cruise West's Lewis and Clark Columbia and Snake River Cruise. Much more than just a trip, it's an experience, a small ship cruising experience, on a river that reveals so much, and a graceful yacht that becomes your week-long window to this wondrous world. Final stop on our Alaska Sightseeing Cruise West adventure is a bit different. The scenery just as spectacular as Alaska and the Columbia River, but this cruise offers something more. It combines great scenery with small seaport towns and big city sophistication. Come explore what's been called the supernatural beauty of Washington's San Juan Islands and British Columbia, Canada, the southern half of the famed Inside Passage. The rugged coastlines of British Columbia and Washington State represent North America's latest cruising frontier. from spectacular mountain wilderness to vibrant cities. See it all from the deck of a small ship.
It's like being an explorer.
Well, it's living a National Geographic. You see it in pictures, and now this is actually living it.
I've never seen anything like it before in my life, and I'm just thrilled to be here.
Here, in a place that just 200 years ago was one of the least explored areas in the entire world, the magnificent coasts of Washington State and British Columbia, Canada.
For the first time, we're actually featuring British Columbia as the destination and taking the time to explore it. We're taking the time to get into the narrow fjords. They're the fjords that were carved by the glaciers, the same glaciers that are now in Alaska.
And you won't miss a thing with Alaska Sightseeing Cruise West. On board your small but well-appointed cruising vessel. This week-long voyage begins in the Emerald City, Seattle. From there, you cruise north along the British Columbia coast to Princess Louisa Inlet and Desolation Sound before heading back down to the beautiful cities of Vancouver and Victoria and on through Washington's San Juan Islands and Puget Sound. Your home will be one of Alaska Sightseeing Cruise West's small ships, vessels that hold fewer than 90 passengers each and go where the big ships can't. Cabins are comfortably furnished with private bath. Meals are casual and out on deck when the sun shines. Entertainment is the easygoing variety. For the most part, you're inside just to catch your breath between events outside.
Just being able to get so close to shore, they're not disappointed when there's no disco.
After leaving Seattle, your first stop is in British Columbia at a spectacular waterway called Desolation Sound, an area long sought after by pleasure boaters whose small vessels were the only ones that could squeeze through its narrow passages.
We found on our trips that we have those pleasure boaters that haven't ventured that far with their own boat from Seattle or Vancouver. They're coming with us to check out this area.
This is beautiful. It's just like meeting a girl on your first date. You know? It's fantastic.
The voyage of discovery continues. You are now 50 miles north of Vancouver at one of British Columbia's most stunning attractions, Princess Louisa Inlet, a narrow glacier-carved waterway with granite walls rising 5,000 feet, as spectacular as any fjord found in Alaska. Cascading waterfalls are all that break the serenity.
There's a sereneness. You can't capture this on film. What it does to the spirit.
You may have the opportunity to step off the ship to explore the forest that comes right to the water's edge.
It's kind of like a fantasy. I love it here. It's like an enchanted forest to me.
The only clues to man's presence at Princess Louisa Inlet are a boat dock guarded by this vigilant blue heron, and at the fjord's entrance, a small collection of log cabins with an interesting star-studded history. The Malibu Club was a Hollywood retreat in the 1940s and is now a summer camp. Now a change of pace. The trip turns south and takes on a British flavor. Get ready to make port in what many describe as the loveliest city on the North American continent.
Rudyard Kipling felt that it was one of the most beautiful cities in the world. He compared it to having the best attributes of many other cities, all rolled into one.
A bit of merry old England, right here in Canada. Victoria, British Columbia.
You get to see a lot of the scenery.
And a nice pace, too.
Victoria offers so much. Optional activities might include a carriage ride past the Parliament with its statue of the Queen. Quite a standout during the day and night. Then past a game of cricket. London double-deckers, and year-round flowering Bouchard Gardens, and perhaps high tea and crumpets at the Empress Hotel. All very, very civilized.
Coming right into the city now, we're going to be crossing under this first bridge.
It's just a short journey to the next port of call, another place so beautiful that the locals say theirs is a city surrounded by envy, Vancouver, British Columbia.
Well, Gassy Jack, or John Dayton as he was known, was born in Hull, Yorkshire, England in 1830.
During the mid-1800s, a settler named Gassy Jack opened a saloon for local gold miners. Vancouver grew up around it, into a city that's cosmopolitan and colorful. You'll have time to explore the city, then enjoy an included excursion up the historic Fraser River, the highway to British Columbia's gold fields. Rested and refreshed from your day in beautiful Vancouver, you are now back on the water, cruising south from British Columbia into the San Juan Islands, 172 islands scattered like rough-cut emeralds across Washington's Puget Sound. You'll go ashore at Friday Harbor on San Juan Island, a popular stop for summer visitors, both human and animal, because offshore, orcas, killer whales, come to play.
When the whales come in, it's just incredible to watch them. They'll sit offshore here, just breach sometimes, which is jumping clear out of the water, and everybody just goes nuts because they're so fun to watch.
You will even have the chance to learn something about the orcas inside the museum dedicated to these fascinating creatures. Your week-long journey wraps up on the Washington mainland. In spring, a flower lover's dream come true, the tulip fields at the artist's colony of La Conner. Finally, one last port of call before returning to Seattle. This one, a step back in time. Turn of the century, Port Townsend.
Small town of 7,000 people in a great location. Great deal of the town is on the National Historic Register. It's actually older than Seattle.
If its quaint Victorian setting looks familiar, well, Hollywood came to Port Townsend in the early 1980s to film An Officer and a Gentleman.
It's a special place to me to be close to nature like this.
You have just explored the best of the great Northwest. You have roamed its cities and towns, its islands and fjords, close up and casual. An unforgettable cruise.
This is an experience of a lifetime.
An experience you will always treasure. The small ship cruising experience through the magnificent Pacific Northwest. And you won't miss a thing with Alaska Sightseeing Cruise West. I hope you've enjoyed this introduction to Alaska Sightseeing Cruise West and the graceful world of small ship cruising. Now for everyone here at Alaska Sightseeing Cruise West, I'm Paul Ryan. New rates and vessels are introduced occasionally, so call for current brochures.
Just what heaven needs to Oftentimes, Satan will whisper. He'll say there's no need to try. 'Cause there's no end of sorrow. There's no hope in the by and by. But I know Jesus is with me. And tomorrow I'll rise where the storms never darken the sky.
No matter the form it takes, black gospel, southern singing convention, modern harmony, or traditional.
Right.
Father.
Like turning the pages of a family photograph album, our memories preserve for us the relationships and events that tell the stories of each of our lives. Happy and sad, joyful and painful, the memories of our days make up the fabric of who we are. Some memories just happen, but great memories are made on purpose. Somebody plans them. Picnics, vacations, bedtime stories, birthday parties, Christmas celebrations, Easter egg hunts, family dinners. And with perspective of memories, we make important choices and form our lifetime values. An unforgettable memory was made when dozens of friends who had spent their lives in gospel music gathered to sing some songs from their own personal treasure of memories. For these folks, many precious memories had begun around a piano somewhere, sharing stories of how their lives had been changed by God's amazing grace.
Thank you.
Albert E. Brumley's son, Bob Brumley. Nice to have you here. Give Bob. And Albert wrote so many great songs.